students of standard 8. Today we are going to learn chapter number 3, that is the American Civil War. We know from your last chapter that we have spoken about the American War of Independence, which took place in the year 1770s. Today we will be pushing somewhere around 80 years forward. We will be talking about the event which took place in 1860s. Okay, so let's go to the first slide. So you already have seen this slide, that is the slide of 13 colonies. So when the War of Independence was going on against the British, there were 13 states which fought against British. And in 1776, you know that when the Declaration of Independence was made, the United States of America, a country was formed, which was the conglomeration of all these states. Now, when we speak about 1860s, these 13 states wasn't just a part of USA. USA was quite bigger. Okay, let us try to understand the expansion of USA from the East Coast towards West Coast, roughly. So you can see the area of the original USA, that is these 13 states which you know, which were formed in 1776. The first areas which were acquired were the states which are known as Old Northwest and Old Southwest, which were added by 1783. So you know when the Treaty of Paris was signed in 1783, USA wasn't just 30 states, some more states were also added in that. Then we see by the change of century, 1803, some more states were added. Now this addition was a purchase. You can understand the states were purchased. Okay. Then by few more decade, one more decade, we have addition of this area and Florida. Now by 1840s, we have three areas, 1, 2, 3, which were added. So these two were the Spanish areas. One was annexed, one was seceded by Mexico to the USA. And we have another territory which was added in USA by 1846. And the last addition which we see by 1860s, I'm talking, Alaska and other areas were added in USA later on. But by 1860s, okay, with the addition of this area by 1853, the mainland USA was formed. So by 1860, this was the United States of America. So we have understood the geography. Let us try to understand another word called as slavery. Now when we speak about slavery, slavery has been there since ancient time. Even when we speak about the Roman Empire, which was mostly linked to slavery, even in other parts of the world, slavery did exist. But when we speak about slavery in South America, which began with the age of exploration. Okay, so South America, North America saw slavery with the age of exploration. When we speak about Native Indian Americans, that is South and North Americas, okay, they did have slavery. There were lots of fights, there were lots of wars, and whoever was captured, there were many other factors, there was slavery. But when we speak about European style of slavery, it was a different style. When we speak about earlier slavery, it was not just meant for generations and generations. It was like one person was captured, he was a slave, then his next generation probably won't be a slave. When we speak about slavery which was existing in South and North Americas, it was generation by slave. It was like a person was a slave. If he or she has an offspring, that offspring will be also a slave. Now, let us talk about how it began in South and North America. When Europeans came as conquerors and settlers in North and South American continents, I will call it Americas, these settlers had their colonies and they had their plantation, mostly the sugar plantation or the cotton plantation, and for that they required lots of working hand. They tried to manage to make the locals as slaves, but later on, because of inhuman condition where these locals were kept, the way they were made to work, even the diseases like smallpox, measles, which were brought by the Europeans, decreased their population. So for that, they required a group of people which were tough, which were immune to these diseases, and which would also work very hard. And when we speak about another continent, that is the continent of Africa, even before the Renaissance, many places in Africa were known for slavery. When we speak about the rise of Arabs, they had mostly slaves, mostly coming, many times they were coming from the African continent. Same thing, same concept were also used by the Europeans. They used people mostly from Central Africa. They were majority of time they were forced, they were pulled from their homes and they were taken aboard and they were sent to the Americas, where they were sold as slaves. Okay, and the next generation, which were also residing in those areas, they also became the slaves. Now let us talk about USA now. By 1860s, USA was also part of this slavery. There was slavery allowed in USA. Mostly the people of African origin were used as slaves in the United States of America. But let us try to understand, not whole USA was part taking part in this. For that, let us try to understand the differences between the economy. Okay? The blue patch which you have were called as the northern states. The red patch which you have is called as the southern states. Now, northern states, the economy was mostly based on manufacturing, shipping. So they had the machineries. They had the impact of industrial revolution. When we speak about the southern states, mostly they were used for plantation. Sugar, tobacco, cotton, these were there. Now, north industries, they did not require much of working hands in it. Machines were there, labor was also there, but it was paid labor. When we speak about southern states, those plantations were labor intensive plantations. They required lots of people working intensely and they required very cheap labor. And the best source of cheap labor was slaves, which were sold, bought once, and they would work for you till their death without any payment. So the difference, you know, industries, plantation. This area required more slaves, so this red patch which you see, they was known as slave states where slavery was legally allowed. When I speak about the blue patch, these were the free states where slavery was in practice. This does not mean that these people of North were against slavery much in the beginning. By we can understand with the help of one law, a law called as Fugitive Slave Act of 1850. As per this act, any slave which would run away from the estates of the owner, okay, would be captured and given back to the owner. Okay, this does not mean that this meant that the person, if he was in South or in North, does not matter, if caught, would be given back to his owner. Now, since we have understood the difference between North and South of USA, let us try to understand how their views, the view of Northern US, people of Northern USA changed. One of the things which influenced this was a book written by Harry Beecher Stowe. That's the picture of Harry Beecher Stowe, who has written the book Uncle Tom's Cabin. It is about a slave named Uncle Tom. And she told about the miserable life Uncle Tom and many other slaves had to face. And along with such books and other factors in North, there was a gap of one idea, that is the Northerners or the people from Northern USA were asking to abolish slavery. And this group which asked for abolition of slavery were called as abolitionists. Okay. One of the greatest advocates of abolitionists was Abraham Lincoln. And in 1861, Abraham Lincoln was elected as the 16th President of the United States of America. When he was elected as the President of USA, the people from Southern states, they knew that Abraham Lincoln will somehow try to push the ideologies of abolitionists and they will try to ban slavery. So what they did? They separated themselves from the United States of America. They formed one new country called as Confederate States of America with South Carolina being the first state to secede from United States of America. That state was joined by other states like Virginia, North Carolina, Tennessee, Georgia, Florida, Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, Arkansas, and Texas. So a new country was formed of the former 11 states of United States of America. These were the states which were in the favor of slavery. Now before we go to the this state also had independence flag, they had their own army and they had their own president. Their first and the last president was Jefferson Davis, which ruled from 1861 till 1865. Now before we go to the war, let us try to understand the division. Okay, so if you see this red line, that was the line which separated, which was the separation of Confederate states from the United States of America. The blue patch, dark blue patch which you see, were the free states. Okay, dark gray patches are the earlier groups which joined the Confederate States of America. Light gray which you see are the states which joined later on in the Confederate States of America. Now, these were free states, these were slave states, but there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 light blue states which were the slave states, but they did not join the Confederate States of America. Along with it, we had other states like New Mexico, Colorado and others. Okay, which did not decide whether they will be free state or they were slave states, but they were part of United States of America. Now, since we had a new country, there was no other option for the government of USA but to declare war against the new country, that is Confederate States of America, so that they could reunite the United States of America. And this led to the starting of the Civil War. This Civil War lasted from 1861 till 1865. In this war, roughly around 6 lakh people from North as well as South died, and much more people were wounded. And by 1864, September, it was already known that the people of North or the government of the United States of America had already won this battle, but the final blow was supposed to be taking place, which took place in the year 1865 April, when the surrender took place at Appomattox Courthouse. The general of Southern States, that is General Robert Edward Lee, the person in gray uniform, surrendered to the forces of Northern states. With this, the American Civil War ended. Then we see is that the Civil War which was fought was to reunite United States of America, but it was also fought to free slaves. In 1863, when the war was still going on, the government of America, under the presidentship of Abraham Lincoln, made a proclamation. This proclamation is called as Proclamation of Emancipation. Emancipation is freedom. Okay? As per this proclamation, slavery was banned, every person was considered equal, okay, and every right was given to each and every person of the United States of America. After 1865, another important incident took place is that in 1865, the Southerners, frustrated by the defeat, one of them killed the President of the United States, that is Abraham Lincoln. Under Abraham Lincoln, the reconstruction of Southern state had begun, and it continued till 1876, when the reconstruction of the whole United States of America after the Civil War was done. So with this, I end my lecture. Thank you.